in your presence. And so we thank you today. We ask that you would honor your word in our hearing today. Help us to not just hear the voice of a man, but help us to hear the voice of our Father speaking by his word. May you bless us. It's in Jesus' name we pray. And can we all say amen and thank God. Good to see everybody today. Amen. I want to first just start with this little flyer. Yeah, let's go ahead and give the Lord a hand praise. I feel you. I feel you. Let's give him a blessing. And so I know you got this flyer here. And so we want to take a little excursion together. Thank Mama Brenda. Amen. The Lord bless us through her. And so we're going to go see this movie together called Jesus Revolution. And so this movie takes up on the moment that happened of revival in the 70s. When the hippie movement was happening, and God broke in, when people were seeking something else, they came to find Jesus. And so how many of y'all know Jesus is still the same? That same Jesus that was working in the 70s to bring people out of drug addictions and bondage and being trapped, he's still working today in 2023. And so I believe we'll go see this together, and we pray that the Lord will use the movie to spark first our own personal revival with Jesus. That individually will be committed to him, individually will be grateful for what he has done, what he's able to do, not only in our lives, but then the lives of those around us. And we pray for a move of God to break in. And listen to this. How many of y'all know that God can do something with just the people right here? If we get serious about him and we want his will, his kingdom to come in this world, God will take a handful of people and make a big difference. It don't take many. You just need a couple willing vessels that's willing to surrender. And so what we're going to do is meet next Saturday here for those that can make it. You don't need to bring no money. We'll hopefully go grab some lunch, and then we'll go to the movie. So I'm working on whether we need to rent a van or we're going to carpool. So I'm going to find that out. But before you leave today, if you want to go, see Sister Zelda and give her your phone number so that way we can do a text message thread. Let everybody know those final details. But we're going to meet here at 1:30, and then we'll go see the movie together. And we'll either grab lunch before or after, depending on the time frame and how we got it set up. All right, so let's give the Lord a hand praise for that. Amen. And let us prepare to turn our attention to this miracle-working Jesus. We are in week 4 of a series we started at the beginning of the year. We first started off with God's New Year's resolution, not focusing on what we were resolved to do differently this year, but what God is resolved to do. And what God is resolved to do is what he's always planned on doing. He says, you will be my people and I will be your God. I will be the one who rescues, who delivers. I'm going to be the one when it get tight for you. I want you to turn to me. And since you have so many distractions, I have to do things to create that moment where you don't turn to that or him or her, but you turn to me. How many of y'all know that Jesus, the God of the universe, is jealous for the affections of his people? I don't know if you ever been jealous of somebody or something, or had somebody be jealous around you. They'd do all kind of stuff because they kind of say, you mine, or that's mine. And so God, the Bible says, is a jealous God. He wants us to have nothing before him. And he will fight his way. He will bogart his way to maintain number one position in our lives. And so he wants us to seek him. He wants us to have expectations that he's going to show up when all the chips are on the table. And so we get our definition we used around miracle. It says a miracle is an unusual and significant event which requires the working of a supernatural agent and is performed for the purpose of authenticating the message or the messenger. Somebody say authenticate. Authenticate talks about make real. I want you to know I'm not just talking about what I'm able to do. I want you to think I'm just jawsing, as we used to say, man, you jawsing. He don't know what I say, I mean. And he said, the miracle comes to prove to you I am who I says I am. John 20:29 tells us this. Jesus said to him, because you have seen me, do you now believe? But blessed, happy, spiritually secure, and favored by God are they who did not see me and yet believe. So he said, for people who didn't see me in the flesh, but by faith in the testimony that the Spirit has made known, you have taken me at my word. You have heard the words in the book, and the words in the book have gotten real in your heart by the Spirit's witness to say, no, I'm not just hearing a story. I'm not just hearing a fairy tale or a fable. I'm hearing it exactly how God said it's supposed to be. I'm hearing God confirm his word. He says, you blessed. And he says in verse 30, Jesus performed many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not recorded in this book, but these are written. Here's the purpose: that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name. So he said, we didn't write down everything, but we did write enough so you'll have enough testimony, enough witness to know that Jesus is the one God sent to save and rescue his people. How many people believe Jesus today? They know that Jesus is the Son of the living God. That was the testimony. Who do you say I am? Peter said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. He said, I've seen enough. I know who you are. Do you know that you could hang around some people and not really know who they are? People can hang around you and been around you for years and still really not know who you are. You could be a sum total of things you've done. There are people who are still holding things against you because of stuff you've done. But you, how many know that you are not what you've done? You still a whole different person, though you've done some stuff, good or bad. It doesn't fully distinguish who you are. So as we step into this fourth miracle, we have, first of all, the first miracle is turning water to wine. And Jesus was proving that one day your joy going to run out. And I'm going to have to provide the wine of life, if you will, the joy that surpasses circumstances. The next week we dealt with Jesus healing the royal official's son. He came and said, come to the house. Jesus said, nah, go home, it's already done. And he said he went to the house, and on his way home, his servants ran and said, hey, your son got better. He didn't just rejoice in his son got better, but he wanted to focus now on, man, who was that just did that? Because he just said words. They said, what time did he get better? It was about 1 o'clock. He said, that was the same time Jesus said it. And his faith locked in on Jesus. The Bible said he and his whole household believed. How did they come to believe? Because he went home and told them. He got specific. Not just that my son is healed, that's great. But let me tell you about who it was that healed him. He has power. He just said the word. I thought I needed him to come and touch my son. That's what a prophet is able to do. But no, he's more than just a prophet. He's the Son of the living God. And then we had last week the miracle at the pool of Bethesda. Man who was there. Listen to this. He was laying on the porch at a place called the House of Mercy. The house where God has pity upon people who are in struggles and trouble. And listen, he had been at that house for 38 years waiting to get his situation dealt with. Nobody helped him. Nobody was able to fix the situation. And then without him looking for Jesus, listen, Jesus came looking for him. How do you know that that's where mercy begins? Where God pays attention to you. You ain't got to cry out. You ain't got to get his attention. God sees you in your struggle and comes to meet you where you are. Jesus heals the man, not by the method of getting in the pool, but by just speaking a word to him. Pick up your bed and walk. Listen to this. You won't have to try to find your rest around here no more. We move in locations. And today we deal with this. I think it's two miracles in one. But the point of these miracles is to show us that Jesus has power over everything. Somebody say everything. Listen, big and small. Meaning there's nothing too big for God that he won't step in and have power over it in your life. And listen to this. There's nothing also too small that he won't come and meet you where you are. Some people be like, that ain't nothing. Don't worry about that. But if it's bothering you, God say, that bothers me. He says, cast your cares upon me because I care for you. If that thing is causing you worry, concern, bring that thing to me in prayer. No matter how small of a detail it is, I want to meet you where you are because I'm trying to prove to you I got you. I want to see you at rest. And so John chapter 1 picks up here where we begin this story. And it's actually, this is actually Luke chapter 4, verse 14. We didn't change that. Luke chapter 4, verse 14 is where it starts. Listen to this. This is after Jesus was tempted in the wilderness. He overcomes the enemy's temptation. He comes out of that. And it says in verse 14, and Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit to Galilee. And a report about him went through all the surrounding country. And he taught in their synagogues, being glorified by all. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. And as was his custom, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day, and he stood up to read. And the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovering of the sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And he rolled up the scroll and gave it back to the attendant and sat down, and the eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed on him. And he began to say to them, "Today this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." So here is Jesus about to step into his ministry. He just overcame the devil's temptation in the wilderness. He's moved forward out of that location as the angels came and ministered to him. And he's headed back home, if you will. And when he gets to home, he goes to church. He go on the Sunday, on the Sabbath day, when they was worshiping. And he took the scroll and walked up and he read this scripture. And what he is doing is moving them out of the prophetic aspect of ministry. They have been waiting on the Messiah, the one who was going to come and do some things for God's people. Jesus comes and he reads that exact portion that comes from Isaiah 61. And before he sat down, he said, "Today, this scripture that y'all been reading for a long time, the one y'all been waiting on," he says, "today this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing." Now listen to the work of the Messiah. He says, "The Spirit of God is on me to do several things." He says, first of all, I'm going to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. So first of all, he takes that first phrase, "I'm going to give some good news to people who are poor and struggling. I'm going to come and talk to some people who are without and let them know you have. I'm going to let some people who've been feeling the weight of being empty-handed, who've been going through life, feeling down on themselves, down about their circumstances, down about what they've been going through, the repetitive nature and cycles that they've been going through." Jesus said, "I'm coming today to fix the cycles. I'm going to overcome and break the curses that bind and hold my people back." Listen to this, from having joy, from having an outlook. How many of you know that your circumstances can weigh you down to where don't nothing look possible no more? It don't look like, it just look like it's dark up the road because of what you've been going through. Your circumstances can overwhelm you. So Jesus said, "God sent me to proclaim to people who feeling like that, listen, it's about to get better." He said, "Not only am I going to proclaim good news to the poor, I'm going to proclaim liberty to captives and the recovering of sight to the blind." I don't know what that weight has to feel if a person has been told they got a life sentence. I don't know the weight of that. I don't know how that lands on you when they say you're not walking around here in freedom no more. No more going where you want to go, doing what you want to do. You're going to sit right here, listen, for the rest of your life. You know that got to be heavy. There's some people who get that news and they like, "I'm out of here." They finna commit suicide. They like, I can't imagine sitting in this, around all of this, dealing with this every day. Listen, they gonna say in their mind, "I'm already dead." There's a losing of hope. Jesus saying, "I'm coming to talk to the hopeless and let them know there's a reason for hope. There's a reason that you can have a positive outlook." Listen to this, even right now in that circumstance. Came to pick you up out of that, pick your head up. You ever heard somebody say that to you? Don't walk around here with your head down. You don't have no reasons to pick your head up or lift it up, but they're telling you there's reasons for you to walk around in courage. He said, not only is he going to proclaim liberty to captives, but the recovering of sight to the blind. That's a big thing. I have no idea what that looks like, what that feels like to be in the, and these two groups are together. To be in prison, to be a captive, imprisoned by something with no way out. And listen to this, not only are you in the location, but you can't see nothing, you can't see. You can't see your way out of that circumstance. Then he says, lastly, I want to set at liberty those who are oppressed, those who've been pushed down, those who've been pushed to the margins, those who have been forgotten about, those who have been squeezed out. No room left for y'all. I want to proclaim liberty, that you're coming out of that, and that you might understand that right now in this moment is the year of the Lord's favor. There's an opening then that Luke begins to talk about this good news to the poor. Listen to Luke chapter 6, verse 19. And all the multitude were seeking to touch him, for healing power was all the while going forth from him and curing them all, saving them from severe illness or calamities. And solemnly lifting up his eyes to his disciples, he said, blessed, happy with life joy and satisfaction in God's salvation apart from your outward condition, and to the end are you poor and lowly and afflicted. What does that mean? Destitute of wealth, influence, position, and honor, for the kingdom of God is yours. Now hold on a second. He comes talking to a people who have nothing, who are, he described, destitute of wealth, influence, position, and honor. You got no status. You got really nothing going on that puts you at the top of the charts. He says, but you are to be envied, because not only are you, listen to this, I know it looks like you have nothing, but listen, the whole kingdom belongs to you. Everything that God has, everything that God has available. Now remember what the kingdom of God is. The kingdom of God is not a location that you travel to. The kingdom of God is God's sphere of reign and influence in the heart of his people. So he said, you ain't got to go nowhere. You don't have to get nothing else. You don't have to climb up no ladder. Right where you are, when you let God sit on the throne, I want you to know you once had nothing. Now you got everything. Why? Because now you got God. And with God, everything you need, he will provide. So you don't look at your circumstance. You keep your eyes on God. So he says, you are blessed. I want to go back because he said this. Blessed, it means to be happy with life joy and satisfaction in God's favor and salvation apart from your outward condition. He said, this is the blessing. When you can be happy and have life's joy, it said, despite your outward condition. But you are now happy and you got life joy, not because of what you got, but because of who you got. And listen, even better than who we got is who got us. When we recognize that the kingdom is mine, God is mine. He said, listen, I will be your God. You can claim me as your own. I belong to you. I've given myself to you. And listen, you are my people. We locked in a relationship. But what happens is, if I don't spend time in that fellowship, if I don't spend time in that relationship, if I don't allow myself to find satisfaction there, and I look away from there and I look back out here, they go depression again. They go worry again. They go looking down on myself again because of what I don't have or what I do got going on. That's why he said, keep your eyes on me. He said, when you are lowly, poor, and afflicted, he says, the kingdom of God is yours. Verse 21, blessed, again, happy with life, joy, and satisfaction in God's favor and salvation apart from your outward condition, and to be envied are you who hunger and seek with eager desire now, for you shall be filled and completely satisfied. You know what that's a word of? That's a word that tells us, just keep pursuing God. Keep chasing after him. Don't get tired. Don't get weary in well-doing. Listen, for you shall reap if you faint not. He's telling us, keep chasing me. It's almost like, come on. Come on, that's all right. Don't worry about that. Keep following me. What you waiting on is up the road. Don't get distracted by what you don't got. Don't turn around because it ain't happened yet. Keep walking with me, and you're going to hit the jackpot. Because what you're going to find is, as you keep walking with me, you're going to be happy just walking with me. You're going to stop looking for what's behind me, and you're just going to be happy in the fellowship and relationship because he's saying, I'm your satisfaction. I'm your joy. He said, those who hunger shall be filled. He goes on, if you flip over, he says, blessed and happy with life's joy and satisfaction in God's favor and salvation apart from your outward condition, and to be envied are you who weep and sob now. Listen, for you shall laugh. He said the pity party gonna be over. Don't you worry, because listen to this. The Bible talks about that in that day, he going to wipe every tear from my eyes. There'll be no more mourning, no more sorrow. He said, listen, he said, cry now, but you're going to laugh later on. It's all right to be broken over the condition of the world, the condition of your own heart, the struggles you're going through. But listen to this. It ain't all just about this. We headed somewhere. There's going to be a day where the conclusion of the matter is going to come, and you're going to find complete rest and satisfaction in me. And we do this progressively. Ultimately, it's going to happen in heaven when it's all over. But there's been some moments in my journey where it's been rough, it's been tough, it ain't got tight, and I done steeled away with Jesus. Listen to this. And my heart done got comforted. My heart has been brought back to a place of rest and peace, because listen to what I've done is I've tasted and seen that the Lord is good. I know where it's headed. I don't have to stay in an overwhelmed state. Now, remember what he's talking about is I want to give good news to those who are without, those who are poor. And he's not just talking financially. He's talking to those who are poor spiritually, those who don't have what it takes. So that's why he says in Isaiah 55, he said, come and buy from me wine and milk and oil with no price. All the stuff you need to make life work right, come get it from me with no price. I'm going to give it to you for free. Zephaniah 3:8 talks now to the poor, and it says this. Therefore, wait for me. For in that day, I will stand up to testify. I have decided to assemble the nations, to gather the kingdoms, and to pour out my wrath on them. All my fierce anger, the whole world will be consumed by the fire of my jealous anger. So first of all, that sounds like that's trouble. God said, I've decided I'm going to bring the world to a place of judgment. I'm going to bring everybody to an account that says, listen to this. This is not just nations in war, but what this is hearts that are in sin. Hearts who have looked at God and said, not you, I want that. God said, I'm going to bring everybody to the account one day and let y'all all know y'all guilty for chasing something else over me. But he says, I'm going to come to a place where I fix everything and bring everybody into account. Now look what he's going to do. He says, verse 9, then I will purify the lips of people, all of them that call.
Yeah, I'm trying to see what I was shorting it.
Yeah. I hear you. He says, then I will purify the lips of the preachers, that all of them may call upon the name of the Lord and shall serve him. So that the army called upon the name of the Lord and shall serve him shoulder to shoulder in unity. So he says, I'm going to purify the lips of the people. I'm going to bring everybody into an account and let them all see they wrong. You're not going to look at the next person and say, you're wrong. You're going to have to look at yourself and say to God, I'm wrong. And he said, out of that revelation, when I humble everybody and they see it right, I'm going to give them one lip. They all going to see the same. stand, listen to this, shoulder to shoulder in unity. Instead of us working against the Lord and then ultimately working against one another, y'all gonna be speaking the encouragement of the Lord to one another. That's what the church is. I believe when we go see the movie, that's what we go see. A group of people who are scattered, who get gathered, and they become a unit. Y'all stand shoulder to shoulder. He says in verse 10, from beyond the rivers of Cush, my worshipers, my scattered people, will bring me offerings. On that day, you, Jerusalem, will not be put to shame for all the wrongs you have done to me, and you shall no more be haughty and carry yourselves arrogantly on my holy mountain. For I will leave within you a people afflicted and poor, and they shall trust, seek refuge, and be confident in the name of the Lord. So here's the Lord saying, when judgment comes, my judgment comes. What I'm going to do is gather y'all all together and let everybody know you deserve a whooping. But what I'm going to do is not whoop you. I'm going to have you put in Christ. I'm going to whoop you. And instead of getting that word about you fixing it yourself, it's going to cause you to praise the Lord. I've had some people, listen to this. I've seen some people get whooped. When you think about Passion of the Christ, how many of y'all seen Passion of the Christ? And you see what Jesus went through? And I'm like, that's what I love. Jesus took the judgment that belongs to us. And therefore, with one lift, we become a people who praise the Lord. He says, I'm going to tear down those who are haughty or proud and prideful. He says, and I'm going to leave within Jerusalem now people who are afflicted and poor, and they shall trust, seek refuge, and be confident in the name of the Lord. This is the Lord's work.
It's in your blood. You got the justice in your blood. You kill. Yeah, it's in your blood. Yeah, it's up in your blood.
Push everything in. You just want to get the right channel up here.
And let you know you're not innocent. And this that he did on the cross, he did this for you. And to now see somebody dying in your place, receiving what you God works it firstly in the heart. He goes on and now we look at the word. He says in Psalm 34:18, he's talking about the promise and the power to those who are overwhelmed, those who are oppressed, those who are going through it. Psalm 34:18 says this, the Lord is close to those who are of a broken heart, and he saves such as are crushed with sorrow for sin, and are humbled in heart and truly sorry for their sin. He said, this is who the Lord looks upon. This is who the Lord saves. Those who have, listen to this, a broken heart. Now, have you ever been brought to a place where you got personal with God and you asked God to really see you and say, hey, Lord, forgive me for who I am. Forgive me for what I've done. Forgive me for the way I act sometimes. In that place, he says, the Lord saves those who acknowledge, but that is humility. That's people recognizing their great need. He says, those who are crushed with sorrow for sin and are humble in heart, truly sorry for their sin. Listen to this power to the overwhelm in 2 Corinthians 1. It says, we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about our trouble in Asia, how we were utterly weighed down beyond our strength, so that we despair even of life itself. Indeed, we felt within ourselves that we had received the sentence of death and were convinced that we would die. Hold on a second. He said we got to a place in our journey where we got so oppressed on the outside. We had so many difficulties in front of us. It said it felt like we had received the sentence of death. You were like, man, we curse right now. We can't get away from trouble. Have you ever found yourself there? Where trouble keep finding you. Things going good for a minute. Next thing you know, here come the monkey Rich in the program. And it just felt like, man, I can't get away from
trouble. Okay, I'll change the channel. I'll change the other.
So he said God had to take us to a place where we were hopeless in ourselves. We couldn't figure out a way to get out of it, a way to get through it. It had so much stuff going on that we were overwhelmed and had our senses to death. But he said God allowed this to happen so we wouldn't trust that we could figure it out. We had to trust that God was going to work it out. This is where God has to bring us. He said this wasn't accidental. This wasn't just circumstances coming with no purpose or meaning behind it. He said God allowed these things to come into our lives to teach us not to trust ourselves, but to trust in Him. God has to break us down to a place of recognizing that all of our help comes from the Lord. I'm going to solve this day. I'm going to look to Him. But sometimes we get in God's way trying to fix you better leave it alone. Get off of it, because sometimes God is allowing the thing to be there. Some stuff you can't pray off. You gotta wait for God to work through. See, this happened to teach us to not trust ourselves, but to trust in God. He rescued us from so great a threat of death, and we trust that He will continue to rescue us. On Him we have set our hope, and He will again rescue us from the danger and draw us near. So now what He said is that past circumstance has brought them to a place that past circumstance has brought them. In the situation, but it said it was because they have rebelled against the words of God. So I'm in this situation, ain't nobody called for my. Now that's what part of me, because when it's somebody else's fault, you got reasons to fight and you can talk and you can argue. But when you in that situation because of what you have done, you can't do nothing but look at yourself. Yo, what if you turn on you, it's all bad. You ain't got no way to look at you already. Isolated, stuck in the situation, and I know it's all my fault. That's a dark place to be. And be like, well, forget it then. I'm just going to go as hard as I can. I'll make it work. It don't matter. Remember, he just said, I'm going to leave the people in this mountain, this area, who have a humble heart, who are poor and afflicted, who have been brought to trust in the Lord. He says he bowed in their hearts with hard labor. If the Lord knock you down, he ain't ever knocking you down to keep you down. He knocking you down to humble you so that when I pick you back up, you'll know how to stand. I want to bring you low in you so you'll know how to stand up in me. It says, there was none to help. Then they cried. Some of us won't cry right until we get in that position. Your prayers won't be real until you get as low as God lets you get. They got in that place with no help, and they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distress. He brought them out of darkness and the shadow of death, and he broke apart the bonds that held them. And the psalmist says, oh, that men would praise and confess to the Lord for his goodness and loving kindness and his wonderful works to the children of has broken the gates of bronze and cut the bars of iron apart. Listen to this. You couldn't get out, but the Lord delivered you. Somebody ever been set free, delivered from the stuff you couldn't get out of? The Lord. He said, oh, that man would praise the Lord. Some stuff you wiggled your way into. Listen to this. Some stuff you fought hard to get to. What you got to do is you got out of the trap. Wanted to get out, but couldn't get out now. And then you had to get to a place of humility. You say, Lord, it's me, I need you to come and rescue me. You come to my rescue. And the Lord didn't stand up and say, I told you so. The Lord didn't stand up with a whole lot of conversation. The Lord comes to your rescue. Listen to this. After you say, the brother said, you was an angel. You was going all back. Recognize and let it go all bad so we can be brought to recognize he's all good. Only he can get us out of our circumstance. So he proclaims liberty to captives and sight to the blind. As we tap back in there to the miracle, we're moving towards the miracle of Jesus who has been sent to do some things, to proclaim good news to people who are struggling and people who seem to have nothing. He wants them to know the whole kingdom to you. Luke 4, 22 to 30 talks about the problem the folks closest to Jesus had with him. It says, after he had said to James, this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing, it says that everybody spoke well of him and marveled at the gracious words that were coming from his mouth. And they said, it's not close to some. You will quote me this proverb, physician, heal yourself. What we have heard you did at Capernaum, do here in your hometown as well. And he said, truly I say to you, no prophet is acceptable in his hometown. But in truth I tell you, there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the heavens were shut up 3 years and 6 months. And a great famine came over all the land. And Elijah was sent to none of them, but to Zarephath in the land of Sidon, to a woman who was a widow. And there were many lepers in Israel in the time of the prophet Elisha. And none of them were cleansed, but only Naaman the Syrian. So let's stop for a second. Jesus has just proclaimed the mission. He just proclaimed what he claims to do in the world. And the people were excited at the words that were coming out of his mouth. And then Ain't that Joseph's son? Ain't we know him? He said not only is he word good, but he said that he's the fulfillment. So though he grew up around these people, they didn't recognize that this is who he was. They heard what he said, but they hadn't yet been brought to see who he is. I had heard about Jesus growing up all my life. But there was no power in what I had heard until one day it got personal and I found out who he was. Not just what he said. Remember, what he said is there to back up who he is. So you have to have both come together. The word has to become real. Remember, I had you say that word earlier, authenticate. To make real, listen, in a personal way. Not just hearing with the ears, but knowing with the heart. And only God can bring that about. So it says, they said, we heard what you said, but the problem I have with what you said is I know who you are. There's some people around you right now. Listen, I heard what you said about you with the Lord now, but I know who you are. I know what you've done. I know what you're struggling with. And don't have an understanding. Listen to this, God that really laid his hand on me. It's okay to struggle. Listen, when you're in God's hand. It's one thing to just lay down and say, forget it, I'm just going to accept what's going on in my life. This is it. But it's another thing to be down and struggle and get back up with God's hand. This is what God brings to people. They move into the next part of it. It says this. When they heard these things in all the synagogue, were filled with wrath, and they rose up and drove him out of the town and brought him to the brow of the hill, the edge of the hill on which that town was built, so that they could throw him down the cliff. And passing through their midst, he went away. Well, they was just happy at what he said. Now it says they was filled with wrath to the point that they took him out of the synagogue and walked him to the edge of the hill with the intention. Throw him over the cliff. Jesus, like a boss, just walked right through. You can't stop me. But what did they hear? Jesus said there was a time of famine. Everybody was hungry. Well, listen to this. I didn't go to everybody. I went to one woman. He said there was a time when people were struggling. He said this. In the time of Elisha, there were lepers and none of them. Salvation doesn't come just because you're born in the right family. He said, you're not going to be saved just because your granddaddy was a pastor. You're not going to be saved because your granddaddy was a pastor. It's got to be personal with you. You're going to have to believe in me is what he was saying. You think I'm just Jesus from over there. I'm Jesus from up there. You got me twisted. You're going to have to personally put your faith in me. The other problem they had was when he said there was a leper who was cleansed. Nobody else got cleansed in the land except for a leper who was, listen to this, Syrian. He's an outsider. He's your enemy. He thinks I'm good for you. Jesus, I came to save the whole world. I got a people out of every kind. He said, I'm saying who I want to say. You don't determine who I am. I'm God. And so with salvation, doors have been done to by the same who did proclaim what I came to do. Set people at liberty who are captive. I came to give good news to those who have nothing. I didn't just come to a certain group of people. I came to make a whole new group of people. People from over there who've been trapped in that, I'm going to give some of them. People who grew up over there who've been struggling with that, I'm going to grab some of them. People say, you don't tell me who to say. Because listen, I'm going to pay the cost. So they missed him, and they said they took him to the edge of the cliff, going home. But he walked right through that cliff. I imagine he had to kind of get ghost-like on him. Like, you see me, but you don't see me. Revealing his power. And it says the next move from that moment was, and he went down to Capernaum. The city of Galilee. And he was preaching on the Sabbath. There go that day again. him, saying, be silent, and come out of him. And when the demon had thrown him down in their midst, he came out of him, having done him no harm. So here Jesus, stepping into his ministry, saying, basically, I got power over everything. He steps into the church. I want you to know, the church just ain't supposed to be for people who got everything good going on in their life. It said that day at the church, had a conversation with the spirit. He had a conversation, listen to this. He had a conversation with what was in that man. I remember being in a place one day, I was in Richmond, you know, was talking about the Lord in those days. He rapped, I was talking about rap for the Lord. I was telling him about salvation. And I was coming to a place like that, let me pray for you. He said, man, I can't do that. This is what he said to me. Devil will have my head. I found out in that moment I wasn't just talking to him, I was talking to him.
Yeah.
I was talking to the spirit within him, but that light was standing in darkness. We were having a conversation that wasn't just in this natural realm, it was beyond this realm. I don't know what he did in his life, but he felt overwhelmed and compelled. I'm a slave to the devil. This was his conviction. He said, I can't do that. The devil will have my head. Do you hear the power in that statement? Somebody has been wrong with the conclusion that I'm locked in these chains. I can't get out. I gotta serve my sentence this way, if you will. Here is Jesus standing in that same place, talking to a man. Talking to the enemy that's in the man. He said, come up out of. And before he let him go, he shook him down to the ground. You know that devil was not on. If you let him get a foothold, he's going to try to take the whole mile. Okay, that's okay. It's okay. I appreciate it. Thank you. It's okay. Yeah, I like it. That's right.
You see, your cats hear you. Your cats hear you.
He said, come up out of. Teaching is this? What kind of magic spell is he doing? Not saying, no, who is this man that just took that out of that man? I've been knowing this man my whole life. And he just spoke to that man in this whole situation. He said, you really love me. When the sun was setting, all one of them and healed them. And demons also came out of many crying, you are the Son of God. Demons knew who he was. First-hand information and revelation from me. It's personal. You don't just say this in the crowd per se. It may get said in the crowd, but Jesus got to just take what's been said, put you in your own individual situation, listen, and confirm that word to you. Though he is the God of the whole world, he's personal. He's an intimate Savior who knows our condition, knows what we struggle with. He said, this is what my ministry is about. That I will come to those who have nothing. Let them know that in me you got everything you need. Those who are trapped and bound and imprisoned and blind, I came to bring light and sight, give hope and give joy to people who've been going through it. I believe part of what God is doing, even in the sending of this movement and moment here, is to bring people who've been struggling to try to figure it out on their own. Let them know you're no longer on your own. Because if I be for you, who could actually be against you? Teaching us, though we got circumstances and situations, to give our all. Father, even today, I pray that you would help us to see your role in our lives. The work you came to do, even as you quoted it back then, you're still doing it today. Even here, you're proclaiming good news to folks who are naturally, spiritually, financially poor, without, don't have the means to get where they need to go, do what they need to do. But Father, you're telling us you sent Jesus to make up the difference so that we who feel empty-handed might recognize we got everything we need. You said those who captives by the enemy. You feel like there's no way out. You came to let us know that you are the way out. That you can open up doors that seem to be shut. You can give sight to those who seem to sit in darkness. Even darknesses that we've created for ourselves. That you'll shine the light of your love and let us know even in that place we're not forgotten about. Because you don't just come to rescue people who've done good. What you've done is gone ahead of us and done good for us. And then you call us as we sit in our wrong, we sit the repercussions and the consequences of our own rebellion and sin. What we do right in that moment is we're brought to see you. Conviction comes up on our heart. We recognize, as David said, against you, Lord, have I sinned. I might have did it to them, but I did it to you, God. I didn't live in honor of your will, which meant I couldn't honor my brothers and sisters. And so therefore, by looking, salvation happens in the looking away from my wrong and now looking to Christ who suffered for my wrong. God, there's hope granted to me. But even me that doesn't deserve access, the door will be open. Father, we pray today that your miracles, what you've done, even in your word, in the big things of saving a brother from being controlled by me, saving a mother from being controlled, they were all on equal footing in your word. Father, we pray even today you remind us that you see us in the same way. Whatever's bothering us, whatever's holding us captive, you'll come to our rescue. Father, this is our prayer. This is our desire. It's in Jesus' name we pray and let us all say amen. And thank God. Can we give the Lord a hand praise? Amen.
So, never be more loved than I am right now. Wasn't holding you up, so there's nothing I can do to let you down. It doesn't take a trophy to make you proud. I'll never be more loved than I am right now. Ooh.
Yeah,
please.
Next chapter is
going to meet here at 1:30.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Going to trade this cross.
for a crime.
Okay, thank you.
But this is not the end. When you call my name, I will take my hand. There's a mansion in glory, and you're gonna meet
when he came up, he'll be a cooler version.
I shall not. He will wipe every tear from my eyes. I shall not. He's on my side. I shall not want. I'll be home in his presence forever. I shall not.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes, sir. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm glad
you came out.
That was it.
Praise the Lord. I wish I could have. Sister Zelda, do we got any more of the flyers? Can you bring them?
Yes. We got a new thing, right? Mm-hmm. Check this out. You put these goggles on, right? Uh-huh. And they put a wristband on your each of your wrist and on your feet. Just okay. A little wristband thing. Uh-huh. And they say, are you ready? And you say you ready, you go to a whole nother world.
Right, that
shit is so crazy.
It's pretty.
Yeah, it's pretty, but it fools you.
Yeah. I haven't done that, but I've done 3D before.
You standing up, but you just got some glasses.
I had to get a mind.
You can take me somewhere else. I got you, bro. We're gonna try next week. Yes, sir.
Check it out.
Colder than a polar bear, so we over there. Where the hurt be, cause the love of Christ is really rare. Let me clear the air, baby, this is good news. Some of that real talk, yep, something that you could use. So you put snooze when the alarm went off. Hey, we've been sent to wake you up, so family, let's talk. Now they thought, yep, that COVID was a pandemic. But it was a pandemic cause I seen God's hand in it. I seen him stand in it, so we ran past man's limits. Threw me in the trenches, tearing down sin's fences. So relentless, we pushed through the issues. Tears and tissue, I just want to be used. Short fuse, we in a ticking time bomb. But it's henna henna, God sin won't last long. Sad song folks sing on the daily. The world is going crazy, everybody yelling pay me. They should be yelling save me. Jesus, please raise me. This ain't the way you made me. Take this heart you gave me and change me. Take this heart you gave me and change me, Lord. That's right, it's a cold world. Uh-huh, that's right, that we're living in. Uh-huh, that we're living in. Cold world. That's what I tell you. I'm on my grind trying to redeem the time of past failure. Since it took a failure, though my work may seem foolish. Plus we go through it, but Jesus did it, so we do it. My spiritual eyes lucid, can clearly see the future. Jesus coming back, motivating my maneuvers. There's truth in the room of Christ the King, he's the ruler. Scoop me like a Uber, got your boy feeling super. Sash me out the stupor, wouldn't let me go out like a loser. On the block like a tutor, raising trays, I'm a shooter. Don't let the devil use you, take your life back. Real empire is the kingdom, we gon' strike back. Hey, we fight back, it's like that. Try to get you on the right track. Better grab yourself some oil and get your life back for the sky crack. That's right, get your life back for the sky crack. It's a cold world. Uh-huh, that we're living in. That's right, that we're living in. Cold world. Cold world. Such a cold world. That's right, that we're living in. Uh-huh, that we're living in. Cold world. Cold world. Such a cold world that we find ourselves in. When brother will turn against brother. Oh, hallelujah. People don't stand to stay connected, but easily fall apart. We need the love of God to come back and let us understand we've been built to love one another. That's right. It's a cold world. Though the world is changing, we got challenges everywhere. We press on. We are not those who turn back, but we press on. Believing in the heart that we can make it through. We don't give up.
We don't give up in this fight. We press on, walking in.
We press on.
Sometimes it feels like midnight.
Like midnight.
We take flight, head to the sky.
No lie.
Sometimes I cry, I know why. Cause there's hope for my tomorrow. No darkness, Christ, he's my sunshine.
We don't
give up in this fight.
No, we don't give up.
We press on, walk in his light.
But we press on.
Sometimes it feels like midnight.
Midnight.
We take flight, head to the sky.
No lie.
Sometimes I cry, I know why. Cause there's hope for my tomorrow. No darkness cracks, sees my sunshine.
Felt the walls closing in, hell's jaws opening. Had me praying to the Lord, please don't let me fall in. To the brim, overwhelming me with them. But he put hope in me again when the light of God was growing dim. The only hope for sinful men towards the end. On my knees of being, this been prayers and supplication.
And a heart preparation for you.
Sent me to the nation, Jesus' the destination. Bring every soul to He who reigns over everything, heaven's door and the key. Place prepared for me, place prepared for we who trust in the blood, yeah, the sinner's perfect plea. May the spirit and the water and the word all agree that salvation is free, but it was paid for at the tree. We don't give up. No, we don't give up. But we press on. We press on. No lie.
Sometimes I cry, I know why. Cause there's no for my tomorrow. No darkness cracks, sees my sunshine.
We don't give up. Nah, we don't give up.
We press on, walk in His light. But sometimes it feels like midnight.
But we continue to walk in His light. We all in, all chips on the table. Cause there's hope for our tomorrow.
No darkness cracks, sees my sunshine.
When the Lord is on your side, you got more than enough. Not just to make it do, but to take it to a whole nother level. Don't be one with the devil, you ain't never gotta settle. Pedal to the metal, our lives His purpose. This was life worship, we believe heaven's verdict. Hey, we not guilty, that's on the bloodstained banner. And the devil can't touch us, Jesus got me on my hammer. This is gospel grammar, trying to make it plain. Heaven and earth gon' pass away, but the word of God don't remain. Now don't look at me strange, we was created for His glory. That's why life ain't a game. Can you feel Jesus' pain? Our life is sin. Jesus be the life ram, don't keep up, keep. We don't give up. Nah, we don't give up. Though we got struggles and challenges, we continue to press on through it all. We all in.
But sometimes I cry, I know why. Cause there's hope for my tomorrow. No darkness crashes my sunshine. We don't give up in this.
Nah, we don't give up.
We press on,
keep on pressing, keep on pushing.
But sometimes it feels like midnight. We take flight, head to the sky. We all in, man, there's no lie. But sometimes I cry, I know why. Cause there's hope for my tomorrow.
For tomorrow.
No darkness crashes my sunshine.
For everybody got signed up who wants to go next week. Taking everybody to see the movie Jesus Revolution, to see that as a community, grab us some lunch. Hey, I woke up this morning with Jesus on my mind before I start my grinding. Even let me take a little time, gotta give God the praise. Hey, give God the praise. I woke up this morning with Jesus on my mind before I start my grinding. Even open up the blinds, let me take a little time. Gotta give God the praise. Hey, we ride for the King. Yeah, we represent the kingdom. And ain't nobody greater than Jesus. And baby, I believe Him. By the Spirit, yep, I seen Him. The Word became flesh. Jump right into our mess just to bring our souls to rest. And yes, I confess, there's no hope without Him. We too short to play with God. We can't even touch the rim. Situation got grim, but He became the way out. A lot of folks thought I was just a phase and all this Jesus stuff's gonna play out. No fear to stay out the way, cause we still banging blocks. Since His mercy don't stop, Jesus' work it don't drop. So if you're hurting, don't stop.
Remember, joy comes in the morning. It's storming. Christ is still performing.
This priestly duty's an advocate seated with the Father. Intercession on our behalf for the one who walked on the water. So when your road gets harder, don't stop, don't quit.
draw life from the word and don't back up an inch. I woke up this morning with Jesus on my mind. Before I start my grind, even open up the blinds. Let me take a little time, gotta give God the praise. Give God the praise. I woke up this morning with Jesus on my mind. Before I start my grind and even open up the blinds, let me take a little time. We gotta give God the praise, He deserves it all. Wrote this on flight 683. I was way above the clouds, on my way back from Nova Scotia, on my wiggle making rounds. The mission man at pounds, in my heart I'm in love. When I was drowning in the flood, He knew exactly where I was. That's exactly what He does. Makes blinded eyes open. Found out that I was told to preach the King in the night of Oakland. Got me flying over oceans. Said He moving, we get motion. In the spirit like we float, dripping with the gospel I've been soaking. The strength that makes me potent, a weapon in His hand. Tell Him use me how He want if He started laying out the plan. So much decay up in the land, we all need Jesus. I'm calling all believers, justified receivers of the grace of the King. More than just a dream, it was more than just a theme. He said live life on mission, victors not victims, baby, this is how we living. I woke up this morning with Jesus on my mind. Oh, hallelujah. He said, if you keep your mind stayed on me, He said He'd keep us in perfect peace. I woke up this morning with Jesus on my mind. Before I start my grind and even open up the blinds, let me take a little time, gotta give God the praise. Give God the praise, man. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. He'll make a way out of no way. He said, you just keep looking at me. That's how Peter was walking on the water. Had his eyes fixed on the master. Even open up the blinds. Let me take a little time and give God the praise. Let me give God the praise. Oh, let's go here. Thank God for His saving work, for all that He has done and all that He's able to do. Psalm 92:1 says, it is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord, because it shows that we recognize His work in our lives. We invite everybody that desires to go next Saturday. We're going to see the movie Jesus Revolution. We're going to meet here at the park at 1:30. Thank God for all the work that the sun did. Give praise for all my sins that the blood healed. My sins became healed. I'm all in. Now I'm all in. Thank God. Thank God for all the work that the sun did. I give praise for all my sins that the blood healed. My sins became healed. I'm all in. And now. Well, I've been waiting, meditating on the good part. Houdini on the floor gave me a new heart. New start, got my mood washed. The true boss is on my side, made humble but still drip sauce. No flaws, cause His cross got your boy off. And I ain't trying to just talk, staying deep talk. Cause He bought all the time I got on the clock. He's the real rock, the one that they can't stop. So don't be shocked if you get socked. Christ built us from the enemy, yep, He got knocked. Hey, He got dropped. Found out He's not, yeah, who we thought, but glad Jesus fought. So distraught when the NFL came, didn't call my name. He said, boy, the whole host of heaven know your name. So stay in your lane, proclaim my name. Thank God for all the work that the Son did. I give praise for all the sins that the blood healed. My sins became His, now I'm all in. Ta-da, ta-da, thank God. Thank God for all the work that the Son did. I give praise for all my sins that the blood hid. My sins became His. Now I'm all in. Thank God. Thank God for His grace. Bless you, Brother Clarence. That's right. Good to see you, baby. Yes, sir. So thankful for what the Lord has done. Look beyond my faults and saw my needs. Thank God for all the work that the Son did. Give praise for all the sins that the blood hid. He took all of our sin away. Thank God. Oh, let me talk to you. Lucid dog lost like a goose stuck in the snow. Then Ogina's gonna pull up on me like bruh man from the fifth floor. Before I knew it, he had already slid through the window. Became the temple, place of worship for the sinful. That's right, the place where sinners meet God at. I grabbed my hard hat for the one who said charge that. To my account, he about everything he say. We took the long way, learned to praise in the hallway. And one day, he's coming back for his church. Without spot of blemish, I'm glad the blood still works. Cause our works can't do it, we ain't got enough. You could work your whole life but never earn enough. The devil tried to huff and puff, he tried to blow me down. But Jesus overcame him at the cross, what you say now? On the block feeling like MJ on the playground. That's right, dirty devil, you better stay down. We give praise. Dedicated to the mission of Christ. No longer making much of myself or circumstances or what I got going on. But now spending my energy and time to make much of him. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God for all the work that the Son did. I give praise for all my sins that the blood hid. My sin became his. He took all of our sin upon himself. Thank God. Hey, thank God for all the work that the Son did. Give praise for all the sins that the blood hid. My sin became his. Now I'm all in. Thank God. Oh, thank God. God, we thank you. We thank you for who you are and what you've done. You have. When it was all bad, you turned it around and made it all good. So thankful. Thank God. To come and meet him, Jesus sent us to feed him, lead him to the creek now. You should only be the gospel intellectual, that's what I think now. Can't stop, won't stop, get it, can't stop, won't stop, cause Jesus did it. If he had not done what he did, there'd be no hope for us. Bless you, my brother. Can't stop, yeah, we represent the real rock. Can't stop, got the drop, so we hit the block. Devil, you better shake the spot. Watch out for God's fly. System on knock. Hey, man, this is destiny, though Jesus kept testing me. Instead, he blessed me, found out faith is the recipe. Message me if you want to know about the king, but if you're a sister, don't mess with me. I already got a queen, everything the Lord promised me. Finally walking in it. That's right. That's right. Hallelujah. Walking in the promises of God. That's right. Can't stop, won't stop. Because Jesus did his part. Oh, hallelujah. He take those who have been overwhelmed by circumstances and he begins to dust us off and polish us that we might discover who we truly are. Diamonds in the rough. Process and purpose. Last week. beneath the surface, trapped in the current, trying to interpret, hey, what's the next step, faith, the best kept secret, guide us through the darkness, that's how God leads us, y'all seen Jesus learn obedience by suffering, went through the process, trusting God, loving neighbors and enemies, not counting people penalties, or complaining about the injuries, and this is the mystery, of the power of the spirit in the human heart, new foundation to stand on, remember that the first moral arc, Vince was justice. Hey, God got the final say, and that's faith substance. Spent years in reluctance before I truly let go. Let God have his way so I could do what I was here for. Hey, to do what I was here for. That's right, yep, to do what I was here for. Time in here rewards your grinding. Christ is the light that shines and keep climbing. We like diamonds formed through the pressure, see a new day coming, so don't stop running through this process, yes, we are becoming more like diamonds, we're not there yet, but he's still working on us, keep walking in the midst of a lot of things, let go of smaller dreams, to walk in the Father's dreams, major schemes, lots of drama, had to pass the test, I had to learn how to rest in the midst of life stress, quit trying to flex, you've been blessed, that's my testimony, with the word hitting in my heart, feel like I got a weapon on me, resting only in the promise of the risen King, he unveiled the hidden thing, hallelujah, that's what the victors sing, quick to bring the good news to the hot spot, we on the block, off top, piece of love rocks, legged chop, pitch a crop, so you can see the truth, we make it plain music, frame Jesus, be the roof. We was in the booth, New Orleans, Alexandria, down in Louisiana, Hammond, Winsboro, as an evangelist, and none of the challenges that came my way to stop your boy. We on a mission around the world to bring God's joy. Not in our timing, but in God's perfect timing. He'll turn it all around. He got to teach us how to wait on him. Don't stop running through this process. Yes, we are becoming more like diamonds shining forever. Diamonds don't start off beautiful and sparkling and polished. They start off as just a black rock. But somebody picks that rock up out of the place it's in and begins to take it through a process to bring it to its full beauty and luster. That's what God is doing in our lives. He's picked us up out of the muck and the mire, and he has his hands on us. And he's working on us through circumstances and situations, teaching us and training us how to trust in him, that we become a beautiful jewel that shines for his glory. Our shine is not about us, but our shine is about the one who has taken us through a process that even though we've been knocked down, we recognize we not out. Oh, that's us shining for the glory of the King. Forever, forever, forever. See a new day coming, so don't stop running through this process. Yes, we are becoming more like diamonds. More like diamonds.
Forever, forever. Forever, forever.
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 We're coming to the close of our time and worship today. So grateful for all of those who serve and prepare food and your diligence of making those things take place so that God's people will be fed in both ways. Naturally and spiritually. Feeling good today about the work of God and his faithfulness. We rejoice and what the Lord is able to do. I'm feeling good. Not just because I got good circumstances. Circumstances are up and down, back and forth. But the feeling rises out of faith. It knows that all things are good and well in his hand. I'm feeling good. Why should it not be? When my king's on the throne and he got me. Yep, shot me with his love arrow. Reached down to my bone marrow. Hey, so thorough. Childhood hurts. When he came through, he healed those first. No curse. Baby, it's gone. I'ma never be alone, man. I'm on my way home. Shalom, I'ma enter that. Hey, I love the Lord. He held them cold winters back. Sitting back when I think about it. Hey, I don't know how hard it was not to doubt him. Man, I mean, really? To say the God of the universe spoke to you, really? Hey, it's silly in the natural, but you can feel it when the truth of the Lord coming at you. Hey, you know what that do? When the Lord pick up on you in your struggles and he got you, you really know it's not you. I had a taste of his grace, won't y'all take a taste too? Better yet, taste three. Got the Father and the Son and the Spirit living in me. May sin free, came to get me. Now I got liberty, you feeling me? Feel good. Feel good. Because he's on the throne. I don't have just good circumstances, but I found out I have a good God. And even when the circumstances are bad, he remains and says, I'm feeling good. Oh, hallelujah, Lord, because you've been faithful. Teaching us how to trust you. Hills and valleys. Feeling good. So good. Hey, check it out. For every single problem, it's only one option but to trust in the Lord. Our times, he got them in his hand. Faith in his plan. Bounce with the stand when other folks ran. The great I am who he is. Mary told Job, brother, you and I did what I did day and night on the first day. That was on the second day, third day, he created land and the seas. Herb building seeds, fruit bearing trees, all enemies, they had to freeze. Jesus walked out, man, he had the keys. Got the keys to death, sin, and the grave. Hallelujah.
I can send it to you. You go on YouTube. I'm gonna send it to you. I'll send it to you. I'll text you. Amen. Shout it out. Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. We're about to close it on up. We're grateful for the Lord's work. Thanking him even now, fixing the mic, got the mic ready. We'll be ready to run on next Sunday. We're feeling good. I don't care what your circumstance says. You got the victory. You are a winner. Because the Lord is on our side. Thanks be unto God, who always causes us to triumph in Christ Jesus. Still my life, his purpose, lived in full focus. Through his grace and peace, serve the devil, notice we gon' live for the King. Hey, and get thanks in everything. Better dreams come from better plans. Avalanche, think was on the brink of falling. Heard a voice that spoke to my soul, it was a master calling. We all in was the only option. Before my body touched the coffin, it was time to get the ready walking. Pretty often, I think about where I'm at in life and where I could have, should have been, man. That's why I get a praise to Christ. Praise that right. And take these heights. Enjoyable, memorable, because he gave his life so we could take that flight. Born past, signed in blood, it makes me feel like winner, winner. Lord made me a winner. Oh, hallelujah. Even in the face of defeat, we got the victory. Deliver, deliver, deliver. I hear you, Lord. Winner, winner, winner. Lord, made me a winner. Oh, Lord, would you come and deliver? That's right. Father, we thank you for the victory that we have in you. We're able to overcome every circumstance and struggle because you never leave us. That's right. Bless Brother Clarence. Oh, hallelujah. That's right. Hallelujah. Go ahead and break him down.